What is up, The Catch fam? My name is John Dawson, and today I will be bringing you our Week 17 must-start players at the tight end position. Before we hop into today's content, I do want to wish everyone here at The Catch fam a very happy new year. Thank you guys so much for all of your support in 2021. Steve and I are both extremely excited to see what 2022 brings for the channel and The Catch fam as a community. Once again, thank you guys so very much for everything you guys did this past year. Go ahead and hit that sub button if you are new and join The Catch family. Comment down below with any questions pertaining to the 2021 fantasy football season, and I'll respond as quickly as I can. And don't forget to smash that like button. All right, week 17, tight ends it is. Obviously, if you got Mark Andrews, Travis Kelce, George Kittle, they are smash plays this weekend. I think that there's a little bit of hesitancy around a guy like Dalton Schultz, who's been phenomenal on the year, number four in most rankings, going up against Arizona, second against the position. And then Kyle Pitts also getting a tough matchup, coming in at tight end five, facing the Buffalo Bills, ranked number three. So I try to dig a little bit deep this week because these are, you know, smash players week in and week out, but they have very tough matchups this weekend. So let's go ahead and hop into things. All right, number one, I've got Dawson Knox, who still one of your top guys, but I just love this matchup. I mean, I get it, Atlanta's not that bad. They're a top 12 team against the tight end position, and Knox has been playing a little bit down as of late. I just think here in week 17, I've got one of those feelings, man, that Knox comes out and has a big game against a bad Atlanta Falcons defense. It's just one of those feelings, man. I think if you own Knox, he's a smash play in the championship. Start him if you own him. Tell me if I'm crazy in the comments down below, but I think Knox is a phenomenal play if you own him. Moving along, we've got Dallas Goedert, who's been on absolute fire, but last week, kind of down, right? Maybe not kind of, pretty much all the way down. 28 receiving yards off of four targets, two receptions in total, so not a great day. In week 13, he went crazy. Week 14, he had a bye. In week 15 against Washington, he went absolutely crazy with 135 receiving yards, and now he gets Washington again here in week 17, and I just love this matchup. I think Philly's going to come out. I think they're going to lay on Washington, fighting for a playoff spot, although both these teams are fighting for a playoff spot, so I like this game script a lot. I think that Goddard has a great game overall. Moving on, we've got Pat Freiermuth, who practiced in full on Friday, coming back from a concussion. Hey, we missed our guy, Pat Freiermuth, here at The Catch. I think he bounces back here in week 17, going up against Cleveland, 18th against the tight end position. I think he'll have a good day overall with the news of Big Ben more than likely playing his last season as a Pittsburgh Steeler. I think he wants to find the young tight end, put up a good game against a divisional opponent. And let's face it, the Steelers, whether you like them or not, whether you think they're good or not, they are fighting for a playoff spot, as are the Browns technically. So I think this is a good game script overall, and I like Freiermuth in this matchup. Moving right along, we've got Gronk on the list. The Jets coming in 24th against the tight end position. I like Gronk a lot. Listen, we faded him after that week 15 game moving into week 16 against Carolina, because my logic here is if you're a defensive coordinator and you got Evans out, Godwin out, Fournette out, well, what are you going to do? You're going to find 87. You're going to X him out. We saw AB show up last week, and I think as long as AB can suit up here in week 17, that's going to help Gronk. But nonetheless, I just got one of those feelings, man, right? I think that Gronk is going to have a big game. I think that the Bucs are going to get up and at him pretty early on. I think that Brady finds his favorite target probably of all time, and Robert Gronkowski, here in week 17. If you own him, don't be afraid of the past 2 weeks. I really do think that he bounces back against the Jets. I mean, come on. If you own Gronk, he's playing the Jets. It should be pretty simple logic. Moving on to two last players, kind of streamer options for you guys who are maybe in a pickle. We'll go ahead and start with Gerald Everett. Five targets last week, four receptions, 68 receiving yards, and a touchdown against the Bears. He's quietly put together three solid performances, a touchdown in week 14, 60 receiving yards in week 15. And last week, like we just said, 68 receiving yards and a touchdown. This week, he gets the Detroit Lions, 23rd against the tight end position. So I really like Everett. More than likely, he's out there on the waiver wire if he didn't already get picked up as a streaming option. So if you're struggling at the tight end position, or maybe if your opponent is struggling at the tight end position this week and you want to wipe out all the tight ends off the waiver wire, Everett's a good option to go ahead and snag up. Speaking of options that are good to go ahead and snag up, let's talk about my guy Foster Moreau, who I think has a phenomenal opportunity here in week 17. Facing the Indianapolis Colts, one of the worst teams in the league against the tight end position, coming in at 30th overall, I think that he's going to have a pretty solid week overall with Waller out, right? Week 15, 65 receiving yards. Week 16, 67 receiving yards. So he's had two performances in a row with solid volume. He's made a lot out of those opportunities. We've seen him be a viable streaming option in the past when Waller's been out, and I don't believe Waller's going to be able to suit up for this game on the injured reserve COVID list right now. So I think that Moreau's got a phenomenal opportunity. I think this is easily the best matchup he's had. Week 15, he had Cleveland. Week 16, he had Denver. The Indianapolis Colts, as good as that defense is, they have some players out right now due to COVID and other injuries, but also as good as that defense is, they are not good against the tight end position. This has been one of the teams that we have loved to stream against on the season. So if you're in a pickle, go ahead and take a look at Foster Moreau. I think he is a phenomenal option here in week 17. And that'll go ahead and cap off the video, man. Let me know in the comments down below what tight end you are planning on using here in the championship game in week 17 for most of you guys. And also, please feel free to drop any comments, questions, concerns down below pertaining to the 2021 fantasy football season. I will happily respond as soon as I can. Go ahead and hit that sub button. Join the Catch family on the road to 1,000 subscribers here at the Catch, and go ahead and smash that like button while you're down there. And once again, guys, happy New Year's to each and every one of you. Thank you guys so much for your incredible support in 2021. There are big things coming for the Catch fam in 2022. Hope everyone has had a safe and happy holiday season. With that, I say thank you guys so much for watching and or listening, and remember, you saw it here. The Catch.